Hello and welcome to TradingFloor.com. In this Asia Market Focus, the FOMC statement. How is Asia reacting? How is this impacting China and what is it likely to be? And we have a look at China's data in July. Is a soft landing still on the cards? And across to Australia, reporting a slight rise in unemployment. How does this affect the pressure on interest rates? And in Singapore, we have Andrew Robinson, Forex analyst and specialist in Asian markets at Saxo Capital Markets. Andrew, thank you for joining us.
Hi.
Hi, and across to the FOMC statement, what's been the response in the Asian markets?
Well, certainly the response that we've seen may be slightly delayed, but generally we are very similar to what happened in Europe yesterday. Asian markets are certainly under the cosh. The markets are viewing the overall statement as a tippy-toeing towards the quantitative easing measures. And I think the biggest question that the markets have is whether these measures will be enough to drag the US economy out of this minor dip, shall we say, or whether it's going to send the whole economy into full freefall. It's not a direct QE per se, and so under those circumstances you would expect the US dollar to retreat dramatically, but we've not seen that, and generally the US dollar is in a rebound mode. Markets are, I think, very skeptical at the moment. Whether it's because the Fed downgraded their outlook for the economy overall, I don't think that's the case, because generally the July data was pretty poor across the board. So that was there in front of us to see. So I don't think that's a factor. I think it's more the disappointment that these measures maybe are not going to be enough near term to actually get the economy going again.
And is there any impact on China out of this watered down QE2?
I think it's not necessarily directly related to the QE measures. It's more a question of whether the US economy is actually going to go into double dip recession. We know that the US economy is the main driver of the global economy. The Chinese economy certainly is not in the position yet to take over that mantle. It's still very much an export-oriented economy. So I think for the moment, any chance that the US economy will falter is obviously going to impact negatively on China. And when we had this, the FOMC coming in tandem with the July data out of China, then I think it was creating what you might call the perfect storm for this certain pretty strong retracement that we're seeing of late.
And across to China, we've got some data out from July. Is how does this play in regards to China's soft landing? Is it still on the cards?
I think the export market for July was still quite strong. It was certainly better than expected. I think we'll have to wait until next month's data to see whether this was all part of the inventory rebuild, the back-to-school syndrome and things like that, or whether it can be extended. I think of more of a concern was the import side of the equation. Certainly the import growth was much lower than expected, whether it's for domestic consumption or for manufacturing for re-export later or stockpiling. The data was very weak, and that certainly is a very big negative for the economies in Asia, which are very much China focused. Australia, for example, and certainly Singapore, Taiwan, and the rest. So generally, the data was seen as quite negative for the trade side. The next day, we had the CPI data, pretty much in line, but certainly higher than the previous months. Industrial production was quite soft as well, which is, again, a concern going forward into the export sector. So generally, a soft set of data, I would say, not a collapse. So the soft landing, I think, could still be on the cards. But I think we're now teetering on the point of wondering whether we are actually going to revert back to recession or whether we can continue what we've been seeing in the past few months. So we're on shaky ground at the moment, I would think.
And Australia reporting a rise in unemployment. What effects is this having?
Well, certainly the unemployment data has been very strong over the past few months, and the market, I think, was getting quite immune to this particular number. Any surprise to the upside could be quite easily discounted as being part of the natural trend. If you look at the number of jobs added, it was better than expected, but the biggest problem was that it was predominantly, or more than 100%, related to the part-time workers. Full-time employment actually lost jobs during the month, and we saw the unemployment rate edging up to 5.3% from 5.1%. So generally, that was a negative for the Australian market, coming on the back of the Chinese data and the FOMC. Generally, it's putting a bit of a dampener on the growth story of Asia, really. I mean, the Australian economy is performing leaps and bounds above everyone else. So now it's sort of taking a step back, and everyone's re-evaluating. I think we'll have to wait a couple of months until we can verify whether we're actually heading down into another recession or certainly a slowdown. But certainly Australia and Asia has taken a bit of a knock this week.
Okay. Thank you for the update from Asia. That's Andrew from our Singapore office. And for expert commentary and analysis on the global markets, visit TradingFloor.com. And you can follow us on Twitter at TradingFloor.com. See you next time. Thank you.